right, we'll take three questions. We'll start off with E News.
Hi there. What part of Diana's life were you most able to personally relate to?
You know, maybe I'm not a mother, and I'm certainly not a member of a family, but I think the thing that struck me the most when I did my research, and certainly when I started to play this part as well, was a combination of the isolation and the emergence from it, the desire to recreate the self and to control the narrative of one's life. I've learned a lot from playing this part, the courage that takes and the kind of inherent beauty in that life path. I just think there was such illumination that came from that desire to kind of burst through that isolation into something beautiful and to try and sort of reach people, see people, be seen.
Hi. I'm Neha with iHeartRadio. You capture the nuances and like little characteristics super amazing. What went into playing the character that way?
A tremendous amount of research. I watched a lot of footage, a lot, and I think that I unconsciously thought that the more time I spent with it, the more I would be able to sort of absorb something by osmosis. There was a part of me that knew that once I got on set and the cameras were rolling, that it was going to be the battle that all actors battle, which is the battle of self-consciousness, self-awareness, of that sort of antennae that's out there somehow. So I wanted to make sure that I was comfortable enough in those, whatever people want to call them, mannerisms or what have you, so that I didn't have to think anymore. So I spent a lot of time watching, and I also worked with an amazing dialect coach, William Conacher, and Polly Bennett, a movement coach who's worked with lots of amazing actors. And that was amazing to have a mirror, two people mirror you while you were in that really vulnerable state of prep. And so that was the combination, really. Yeah.
Next, we'll go to Enigma Magazine.
I think it's much more challenging. I sort of can stand in, I can sort of straddle two planes, the plane of a person who looks at this person that this character is based on with just total awe and love and admiration and many, many question marks that will go unanswered. And then I had to kind of discard that and try and create something. So it was a really unusual process, and one that took a lot of time for me and kind of funny amounts of courage to convince myself I could do it. I think at the heart of that fear that I felt at the beginning was this sense that I owed something to the audience, something very specific, which was capturing something that would give them a sense of a person who is profoundly loved and profoundly missed. And so that was a kind of a totally unusual entry point into a role. So I'm looking forward to creating something where I am the authority from the get-go. It's also been, because it was so challenging, it's also been incredibly joyful and satisfying to do.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Congratulations. Thank you.